were all high school students, believing that where we had come from, what we had gone through, and where we were going would fit into the vision we had created over the past 4 years of our world, your world, how we all expected it to happen.
This is a journey, not just to our immediate past and present, but to the potential future for the whole world, which we will shape with our own ideas, beliefs, and actions. This is not our end, but only our beginning.
Conceived in the destruction of 9/11 during a recession and graduating in the midst of a pandemic, we have been forced to grow up not just for ourselves, but for the whole stake of the future. And now, we are venturing into the unknown at a time full of uncertainty, spearheading a revolution.
When we leave high school behind, we will not just blend in with the rest of the world. We will change it. They say youth is naive, but youth represents the power to change. And a lot has changed for us this year.
No more prom, senior fest, or a chance to see our teachers and classmates for these last spring months. We have been led to accept a virtual existence as our reality.
The hallways are now empty, and we will not walk down them again. The classrooms are vacant, and we will never learn in them again. Instead, we find ourselves marching in protest, fighting to end injustice that has persisted for 400 years.
Instead, we find ourselves angered at a president who hides in a bunker instead of helping his people.
Instead, we find ourselves struggling to end global warming, a mess created by past generations who now expect us to clean it. We were born in disaster, and now we must grow up faster to face it. So what has that taught us?
After all these years, we have learned so much, both in and out of the classroom. And we are not done growing and becoming. We have been taught how to make every moment everlasting and to give strength to each memory.
These are the experiences that bind us together in a universal senior existence.
Each one is unique, and that's what makes us strong. The culmination of our experiences will, one day, translate into the world. We are just as much a member of society as we are an active component of it. We are becoming leaders, scientists, doctors, artists, writers, teachers, lawyers, mechanics, electricians, plumbers, anything we set our mind to. Our voice is the world's. Our voice is the next generation's. We will no longer beg the world to listen. We'll demand it.
We are senior strong, and this is the story of our strength.
Our diversity is our strength. We stand together, but separate.
The experiences we have are unique, but they form a single universal concept, what it means to be a high school student.
We can talk it so good, we can make it so divine, we can talk it good, how you wish it would be all the time. The drink you spill all over me, lovers spill left on repeat. Mom and dad let me stay home and try to quit and get it home. The drink you spill all over me, lovers spill left on repeat. Mom and dad let me stay home and try to quit and get it home. Feeling sweet, we more alone. It feels so scary getting old. We can talk it so good. We can make it so divine. We can talk it good, how you wish it would be all the time. This dream is the feelings we were reeling through the midnight streets, and I've never felt more alone. Feels so scary getting old. This dream is the feelings we were reeling through the midnight streets, and I've never felt more alone. Feels so scary getting old.
We are more than our test scores or grades, more than our likes, views, or comments on social media. We are defined by what we do and how we affect others, the relationships that we have with people, how deep our bonds are.
Some of us have known each other for a decade. Others have only known each other for a few years, or even a few months. We have grown together, learned together, and whether we realize it or not, we are just as much of an influence in other people's lives as other people are in ours. We don't often think about how our friends have shaped who we are, and how our personalities have pushed us towards each other and pulled us away from others. We are so much deeper than our demeanors or hobbies.
I could stick around and get along with you. Hello, oh, oh, oh. Doesn't really mean that I'm into you. Hello, oh, oh, oh. You're alright, but I'm your darling to enjoy the bar. Hey! You're alright, but I'm your darling to enjoy the bar. Hey! You're alright, but I'm your darling to enjoy the bar. Hey!
I'm a man.
Fades away, we will be left with the memories of the people we shared laughs with, the people we went through thick and thin with. We take from and give to each other. We can choose to lift each other up or bring each other down.
The lessons that we glean from other people teach us about what it means to be human, to possess kindness, patience, and consideration. Not only to be a good friend, but to be a good listener, a good shoulder to cry on. Like threads, we follow different paths, but weave together the whole story.
Welcome to Bloomfield Middle School, everybody. So this is where we started middle school, obviously. The best middle school in all of New Jersey. So many amazing memories here. So many great things came out of this place. And we really started to get to know each other. Like all of us, all of our class of 2020 really got to know each other here.
Had a really good time in middle school, even though I think everyone was just in an awkward point in their lives. But like Vinny said, I met a lot of my friends that I have now.
I came into middle school super immature, and now I'm slightly less immature. So I think BMS for that.
So what are we going to rate Bloomfield Middle School?
A 6 out of 10!
Welcome to Duncan!
Woo! So not too many school memories here, but I have gone here a few times during the school week.
I used to walk here from work. Like before work, I used to walk here, get my cup of coffee, and then go to work. And medium iced coffee with caramel swirl.
Right.
The best thing to ever be made on this planet. So props to Duncan for the memories.
Before senior year, I didn't come here that much, but during senior year, while we were in school, I would come here like 2 times a week for after school coffee runs. So many good memories from senior year in
What are we going to rate Duncan?
7 out of 10.
The Giancarelli's Bakery, where both Vinny and I work.
This place definitely is a really sweet spot in my heart. I've worked here for the past almost 2 years, and I've loved every second of it. This job gave me a lot of really good memories. It allowed me to become a lot more responsible. You know, I became a lot more aware of the decisions that I was making, and as I became more responsible and I grew up, really, it just helped me become a better person.
I think every job has its ups and downs, but Giancarelli's Bakery is definitely a great place to work, especially when you're working your first job. And I've made, I think, so many good connections with my coworkers, and it's honestly a great place to be when I'm not super stressed out and want to die there.
I have gotten bread here twice. Quality. That's all I have to say. Molly would always bring a loaf of bread into our English class, and it was really fun.
I brought him bread too, actually. So that's funny because you're not the only person who brought him bread. Every other day I would bring him a panel, and I just think that I was the best bread maker. So
what are we going to rate Giancarelli's Bakery?
A 9 out of 10.
So the Pit, very, very notorious. Great fries, great chicken strips, best food when you just got out of practice or you just finished up a really hard test and you want to hang out somewhere after school. A lot of memories, small place, but everybody is there after school. This place is always packed and you are always down to make a memory.
I just remember people getting fries in the Pit before soccer practice. So that's kind of like nostalgic for me. Personally, I didn't go to the Pit that often, but I would always see everyone with Pit fries, and to me it would look so appetizing.
I basically like lived off of the Pit during the musical season and in between choir rehearsals and whatnot. The Pit, iconic.
So what are we gonna rate the Pit?
A 9 out of 10.
Today we're at Bloomfield High School. A lot of memories here for us.
So I remember waking up every morning with senior privilege and trying to find parking on State Street and not succeeding and getting to school really, really late because I couldn't find any parking and sort of crying in the morning. But other than that, I really did make a lot of great memories. There's so many great teachers here, so many great people here that really want to see you succeed and really strive to help you and really make your senior year the best and your high school experience the best.
I used to wake up at 5:30 to go to the high school every morning. So that was pretty rough, but I remember going on the bus with that one or driving with her, and that made my mornings pretty cool. And in general, I loved having to like meet new people, but also get. Honestly, these 4 years have been something I'm never ever going to forget. I probably won't even have this much fun again, because high school really is great. Even though like I remember being so stressed and like literally like having a mental breakdown over all the work, I think it really paid off.
I think one of my favorite memories ever is like when Ms. Rinaldi would take our AP Bio class outside and we would go to the pit or lunchbox and get food and we would just like have a picnic. That was so fun. But other than that, like all my teachers were great and I made the best friends at high school and I don't think I'll ever get closer to anyone in my life. So, yeah.
So what are we going to rate Bloomfield High School?
A 0 out of 10.
State Street Grill. Great food, great memories, great night out. I went here after homecoming and had the best waitress of my life. Literally the sweetest person on this planet. And I just remember getting some bomb food, especially at a time where I really needed it. I was exhausted, I was sweaty. Literally, I was sticking to the back of the chair in the restaurant and I was like so embarrassed. But honestly, a really great place to come after school or after an event, so.
I'm not the biggest fan of the food here. I do like it, but it's not like my favorite. However, I do have a lot of great memories at State Street. Like going here after homecoming every year, that's like a big tradition for me and my friends. And we always have a good time.
Yeah, I would also come to State Street, usually with them, after every like show or game or event. And we have really great memories.
So what are we going to rate State Street?
7 out of 10.
Hi
Alright guys, we're at Foley now, and we're gonna talk about favorite memories here.
So, Foley Field is always a great time. Whiteout games, football game, super fun night. I'll never really forget any of the times I had at Foley Field. It's just so many memories I've made over the past like 4 years. Just constantly coming here and just having a really good time.
I'll always remember having soccer practices, soccer games here. Honestly, that's what I remember Foley for the most, just soccer. And soccer's been a really important part of my life, especially throughout high school. So those are my biggest memories here.
I think like the football games really brought the school together more than almost any other sport. And I remember coming to the football games and really feeling a part of a community at Foley. So I really appreciate those memories when I'm older.
So what are we gonna rate Foley Field?
10 out of 10.
So Holston's is a really good place, also really, really good food, very well known, great ice cream, great dessert, and lots of good memories there too.
I think Holston's is okay. I remember just recently going to get ice cream there with my friends, that was pretty fun. I can't say I've been to Holston's a lot, but it's a very classic Bloomfield place, and I think it really is like a major icon for our town.
Definitely. One of my very good friends works at Holston's, so I've come a few times to visit her, and I have a lot of great memories getting ice cream here and just like winding down after an event.
What are we gonna rate Holston's?
7 out of 10.
Quink.
Sushi U, 10 out of 10.
The class of 2020 has faced challenges not many have before. We have been thrust into an evolving and uncertain world where it feels like everything is at stake.
We started freshman year with the election of a new president, which would shape us for the next 4 years.
And now, more than ever, we realize that this country's problems run deeper than what we might think.
High school is only a microcosm of a society that is filled with love, hate, and fear.
With inequity and violence, with division and struggle, with both victory and tragedy.
So what is this world? How does what we know it to be affect what it really is? We have the power to change the world, to make it a better place to live in. Not just for ourselves, but for everyone. We can take the earth within our own hands and shape it into the vision that we create.
High school has become the space for us to form opinions. No longer do we stand and watch the world go by. No longer do we wait for the people around us to make a decision. It is up to us to make the world better, and we are strong enough to do it.
We should seek the possibility to learn, to grow. We are only as limitless as we allow ourselves to be. I want to be in love with experience, with knowledge. I want my friends to be too. We are capable of a universe of acceptance and beauty. These last few months have bestowed multitudes of wisdom on us and experiences we will never forget.
After quarantine ends, I don't want society to forget the lessons it learned. That it's okay to slow down, to breathe, to lay under the sun and appreciate life for its existence. The world is so much more beautiful than the plans we have and the places we want to go. I don't want to live every day like it's our last. I want to live it with excitement for what's to come. Every morning can be wonderful, if we accept that as the truth.
We don't wait to be long. The world we live in is becoming ours. The lives we are aching for are not waiting. We will be the ones to create them. We have to grow, individually and with each other, changing alongside the world.
We have to aspire for change, because without a spark, there will be no fire. We have to be willing to fight for what we believe is right. More importantly, we have to fight for each other and with each other. We are stronger when we stand in solidarity.
We will go into the future with an open mind and open heart. We will be rid of ignorance, and we will become educated and excited
It's up to us to mold the world into what we want it to be, as we too begin to reshape ourselves.
And I want to live in a world where everybody can be themselves, nobody's being judged, nobody's being oppressed, nobody's being held down because of the things that they can't control, or even the things that they can control, because people should just be able to express themselves and be themselves. I don't understand why there are people being discriminated against for their color, for their religion, for their race, for how they wear their hair even, which I think is absolutely stupid because people wear their hair as a way to express themselves. I dye my hair to express myself. I wear it curly to express myself, and I don't see why it might be. That's just something I'm really passionate about.
I want to live in a world where we can see beyond ourselves, where the problems that plague us don't make us blind to everything else. I want a world that is happy but not ignorant, invigorated for the future and for change, but not too worried to overlook the present. I want to live in a world where we can lay down in the grass and exist for the sake of it without worrying about what we have to do. I want the world to not be so afraid, because fear makes people blind. And I don't want to be blind anymore. I want to see it all.
I really feel like if the new generation steps up, we can live in an amazing world. I really want the world to be as peaceful as it can be. I really want it to be as inclusive as it can be. I want us all to just be happy. I really do think that there's so many things that we can fix.
I want to live in a world where everyone understands their value and self-worth.
I want to live in a world that isn't cynical, a world that is passionate rather than indifferent, where change is not held back, but instead met with both open arms and ears. Where we do not fear what is different from us, but instead choose to
embrace it. I want to live in a world where everyone isn't judged by ethnicity, without even saying a word. I wish for a world where everyone isn't divided.
Mr. Iancito once asked us to write a timeline of all historical events in the world on the board of his classroom. We found that what we could not remember, another person did. And then we ran out of space to write every single thing that had happened. Now, if we were to do it all over again, the board would not just be more cluttered, but would be more illustrative of our minds, our values.
We would again find that the spaces we left would be filled with another's memories. We learned that if we thought about it long enough, life as we know it to be is just like that. We are always leaving pieces behind, and our peers are able to fill the spaces that we can't. We are there for each other. And no matter the circumstances, we are never truly alone. We may find that there's a hole that we can't close by ourselves, but someone is there to help.
Our generation fights for one another. We fight for the rights of our peers to exist, to love, to breathe. We lend a shoulder when it's needed. We are woven together, like threads in a tapestry. Our lives are forever intertwined. And that is even more solidified now.
We share an experience that no other class, no other generation can even begin to fathom. We were born into chaos, and we enter adulthood into something worse than chaos, uncertainty. But we started this together, and that is how it'll end, virtually or otherwise. We are the generation of change. We are what society craves, because what we learned is that society will not shift unless we make it. Society is steadfast in its desire for normalcy. Ironic for an entity that reconstructs itself so often. It is never seeking something different. It is never looking for change, but it will come. Society is a collection of mainstream ideals, and it will never be anything more unless we want it to be.
So, what is it that we've learned?
In order for this to become reality, I will continue to treat everyone with respect. Preach that it takes no effort to show each other support and anything we put our minds to. Baj Ayoko Tipsion.
In order for this to become a reality, you have to believe in yourself as strong as you believe in your dreams. Because if you can dream it, you can do it. Find your goals with real passion, you'll see how much further you can go. Remember that it isn't weak to feel, and that it isn't pathetic to hear. It is strong and it's necessary to be tested, but all the money keeps the world safe.
And if we truly do work hard enough, we can fix this thing. And, you know, generations ago, it used to be way worse. And yes, it is better now. The world is a better place now. But there's still so much that we can fix. And we just have to work towards it. And we can really achieve anything.
In order for this to become a reality, I will try my best not to be jaded, but to be hopeful and open to others. I will judge less and listen more.
In order for this to become a reality, I will do things for myself. I will lay down in the grass and breathe heavily. I will soak in sunlight and pull my friends down with me, listening to my favorite songs. I will seek change when there is nothing but deafness, scream with crowds and speak it into existence. I will go forth towards adventure, towards explorations, because I will see everything. I want to become it all, and I want to do it with my friends alongside me. I know I can only inspire the people who listen to me, but I will not stop speaking it out until I die, until my last breath is but a whisper in the wind.
And in order for the world to get to a point where nobody's judging anybody, I think everybody's going to need to have a sit-down talk. Like, the adults in this world need to have a sit-down talk and need to explain it, and then those adults need to explain it to their children, and then this has to keep happening over time, because I feel like if this doesn't, like, if you don't reinforce it, everything will just go back to the way it was. Because there's somebody who's going to find the history of the world and be like, these people thought this. Maybe, what if they're right? And then they're gonna try to start doing that and bring it back and know, because we need to be moving forward and never moving backwards. So I think in order to do that, we have to talk about it and reinforce it so we can get to a point in time where everybody feels okay to be themselves and express themselves and live their life the way they want to. Bye. Thanks. It's been a nice 4 years.
The world is forever changing because of generations like ours. Loud, passionate, reckless, and full of youth. And just like the world we seek to shape, we, too, are ever-changing, and we are doing it together. The future may be uncertain, but we are unshakable.
When we were kids, we pictured high school to be something meaningful, something exciting. We imagined trips with friends, long nights, adulthood. Our lives had built up to senior year, the best year of our lives. Senior fest, prom, graduation, and finally college.
We were supposed to go into the world together. We were going to step into college or the career field, our friends, families, and teachers over our shoulders.
Instead, we were met with disease, fire, and tear gas. Prom canceled, our graduation made virtual, but more importantly, our friends are at arm's length. There, but not quite. No, we didn't get the ending we dreamed of. No, we did not imagine the year to end like this. But it is because of our losses that we become who we are now. Dreamers, doers, visionaries, idealists. We do not seek change, we create it. We become it. The class of 2020 is defined by the fires all around us, which have shaken the world and uprooted age-old institutions. We are defined by the scrapes in our legs, the gravel in our palms as we stand up after falling down.
The world we live in hasn't been kind to us from the start. It has surely overlooked us as we grew up and as we learned to use our voices. But we don't need the world to be kind. We are wiser than its arrogance and more creative than its tradition. We are not the adults we dreamed we would be, and that is not our weakness. We are the youth, reckless, fast-paced, and the world isn't ready for us.
It does not matter who we will be. What matters is who we are right now. And this is who we are. Passionate and emboldened.
But above all, we are senior strong.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see